After 3 months spending time with my family in Java, I decided to go back to Bali again. I still don't know what to do, but I'm just worried about my house. So now I'm heading to Semarang train station. From there, I will catch another train to Surabaya. In the very last minute, I managed to reach Semarang train station. As soon as I got my boarding pass, I get on the economy wagon immediately. Only took 4 hours to take me to Surabaya train station. I'm leaving Surabaya train station and heading to the bus stop. I need to find the bus to go to the airport. I need 2 buses to reach airport. And finally, I reached Juanda International Airport. It will take only 1 hour from Surabaya to Bali. Finally, I'm in Bali again. And I'm leaving the airport with this bus. I need to change another bus to reach the town. Finally, I reached Sukawati Art Market. Before heading home, I had some lunch. From here, it's only 4 kilometers to reach my house. I'm leaving Sukawati with Gojek. It's an online motorbike taxi. Only 3 months since I left, and the witch reached my house again. Another work to be done. Let's see inside. This should be from the cat. These are bird's poop, and I haven't fixed this yet since my arrival, and I have strong feeling to fix it soon as I also need it. Another problem with bathroom sailing. Some has fallen, the rest may follow, and it could happen anytime, and it will be dangerous. My new tiny lamp. As I look to the moon, I commit to fix all the problem in the house. This includes the scooter. Somehow, the machine need to operate again. I bought new tap and asked the handyman to replace the old one. But it's working again, and I send my scooter to the official dealership to be fixed. Another issue with the pipe, it's leaking. But I have committed that I will fix all the issues. I asked the handyman to fix the bathroom ceiling, and magically it's fixed. And to my surprise, I got the call from this dealership with only 2 days since I sent my scooter to inform me that my scooter has already fixed, which cost only $35. So I went to the dealership to pick up my scooter. It felt super joyful to be able to drive on it again. And then I thought about my driving license as it already expired. So I went to the resort police office to get the new one. In this office, I needed to do some tests. And luckily, I managed to pass this test and I got my new driving license. I also noticed that my scooter registration certificate has already expired. I needed to come to 3 different offices to renew it because I couldn't provide the document with the same address as it's registered. So basically, I needed to change the address in the new certificate. It required time and also money. Luckily, everything went smoothly and I got the new certificate. I keep doing my routine, cooking, running, yoga, and I enjoy my time alone since I live alone here. And somehow, I need to make money. But I don't want to do 9-to-5 jobs, so what should I do? The scooter and the house has been fixed, so there is no reason to not doing anything. Then I remember some guest house that I stayed when I traveled to Georgia and also Armenia. I could do the same as them. But some question come up. Who would be the guest? Who would like to stay in the house? As the location is not the center of Bali like Kuta, Denpasar, or Ubud, there are some nearby tourist attractions like waterfalls. But it's not that near also. It's like 4 kilometers from the house. And to the beach is 3.3 kilometers. And it's also not that interesting with the black sand. So I'm not sure that the house could attract some tourists to stay. But nothing to lose, right? It's not like restaurant business or shop business. As the house will still be the house with or without customers. Then I make up my mind. So I went to the furniture shop to buy some cupboards, bed, and other roomware. And finally, the hotel is ready.